It's a time again when the archaeologists come and start digging up by the church, and I go and make a record of what they're doing. They've been here a couple of weeks now, and this is their final week, and they've been somewhat restricted where they can dig because of land ownership, property rights, and people not being very cooperative and demanding outrageous sums of money to sell a little piece of land which is never used. Never in my 15 years here have I ever seen it ploughed or used or anything. So we'll go and see what they've been up to. This is that sacred field, and every year the owner puts these rocks in the way so that there's no access. But no one comes here, so I don't see the point of him doing that. And then just beyond here, there's another strip of land belonging to somebody else. And they have to negotiate for permission to cross that as well. So the work they've been concentrating on this year is to restore the perimeter wall, or rebuild it, as the case may be. But I can hear the generator going, so they're obviously working there now. And I'll show you some pictures that I've been taking over the past couple of weeks to show the progress of the work. Back to the site. Everyone is off in the woods having a cup of tea or something, but they've been very diligent and finished this whole section of the wall. It looks so fresh and new, but it'll be tempered over time, I'm sure. But pretty much all this was rebuilt, but on the other flank, the inside flank, they'll keep the original structure, I'm sure, but this had to be pretty much rebuilt, most of it. This is the turret at the end, which they did last year or 2 years ago.
And we were very interested in finding the towers. We assume there are four for sure towers, maybe five. And this is why we opened this area that we assume there is a one tower, and we excavated it. It's semicircular. It has a radius 3.3 meters. And it's built on the outer side of this defensing wall of the fortress. And the wall is really astonishing.
And here's the view from on top of the wall. The structure at the end they uncovered a few years ago, and now you can see that the church has had its temporary wooden roof removed. So let's go and have a closer look at that. As I said before, there are certain land issues that need to be dealt with. The church and the wall were bought by the local council in order to facilitate that the archaeologists could dig there. But the rest of this meadow is owned by somebody else. And although they have been digging and they've uncovered wonderful structures, and the lime kiln and the bag, although the bag had decayed, the bag of 9 Roman coins shoved into a wall, lots of wonderful discoveries.
And we found a Kaksaveli patch to make a mortar.
Oh, a lime kiln.
Kiln, yeah. And this lime kiln was made before the house.
It's older than a house.
It's older than the house.
Yeah. We have evidence that in time of making the house, some construction man probably lost his wallet.
During these years of digging, the archaeologists have widened their knowledge about how people lived here and how they constructed their dwellings. But finding the metal frame of a wallet with its contents of coins, along with a mason's plumb weight, gives us for the first time a sense of a person behind the artifacts. Among the handful of coins, there is one that appears freshly minted. It shows a proud, noble face that betrays no sense of an empire on the verge of collapse.
It was a coin from the time of the Emperor Valentian, from the second part of the 4th century. He was very important for this part of Europe, for Croatia, because he was born in Cipale, today's Vinkovci, in Slovenia. And it shows the significance of our site in the period of 4th century.
Holding the coin in our hands, we can gaze upon the exact face of the man who once owned this coin, more than 1,000 years ago. And across the millennium, we can make a connection with that man, limited only by our imagination. That between then and now, between him and us, we have a shared experience. It is a deeply moving discovery that enables us to feel for the first time a real human presence behind the objects that are being dug up.
But it seems they don't have permission at the moment to dig here. Land is the most contentious issue here, and people will fight over a few centimetres of land if you encroach upon it. So at this corner, there is a turret which they haven't excavated, and the wall which I showed you earlier continues through the wood and continues here. You can just see the rise where the wall is. And the wall continues through the wood, and just here there is another turret which hasn't yet been excavated.
Probably it could be a gate tower.
And this is their camp where the archaeologists hang out in the shade.
More or less a straight line from this, with these red points, with this adobe they had for building their huts.
Mm-hmm.
I think there is one hut, and maybe here a second hut down to this ditch, but all of this mixed material here.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is still removed prehistoric material, which was removed in late antiquity in course of the buildings they did here.
Uh-huh, so there were structures here before, perhaps domestic dwellings before they built the wall.
Yes, of course. Yeah,
uh-huh.
The two ones there, they should be prehistoric.
Really,
should be late Bronze Age, early Iron Age, which is the most prehistoric material here, would be very likely. Maybe we have another one in the Tower 13, mm-hmm. up there, which is in an angle to these ones.
Okay,
it looks like
yes.
Because,
and, but this and, you can and, see and, in the inside the tower.
Yeah, inside.
Oh,
the tower,
right.
Yes. Yeah, and this is still. This has to be removed still. So the original terrain, or let's say the terrain the prehistorians left, let's say it like this,
mm-hmm.
it goes down here a little bit, and here it makes a ditch or something like that, or it's going down, and it was filled up with material which was of course more prehistoric material which was here from the place.
Right.
They didn't fill it up with stones, but they filled it up with the earth or clay they found. And of course, there are millions of prehistoric finds in there.
Yes, yeah, pottery.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Mostly pottery, but also this adobe. So this red spot in there, this is this clay they used for making the huts with wooden sticks and
we call that wattle and daub.
Wattle
and daub.
Yeah, wattle and daub. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. what it's called. Yes,
even that's a medieval practice as well.
Yes, of course. Yeah, they do it always. Yeah.
There's no evidence of post holes or anything.
Not yet. I have two in this other.
In the tower,
maybe dwelling, in which we at least cut in the tower. But here, I don't see ones. I don't see post holes here. Maybe the two small walls are a little bit later because they don't run beneath the wall and they don't show. They don't look as if they were cut by the wall.
Oh, I see.
So they could be built towards the wall as sheds
or
something like that. Yes, but how long after the wall we cannot tell. The wall could be 5th century and these dwellings, this small could be 6th century or early medieval or they could be next week.
Yes.
So this is not easy to tell. You could tell it if you had plenty of contemporary
findings.
Yes. Yeah.
That's it for another year. The more they dig, the more questions are thrown up of which they have to find answers. That'll come in time, I'm sure.